Ever snagged a window seat on a flight and found yourself captivated by the world miniaturized below? Takeoff and landing are thrilling, no doubt. But there's something magical about cruising above the clouds, right? As you gaze down at the cotton ball landscape, you might wonder, why is our plane flying at this particular altitude? It's not just a random choice, folks. There's a whole lot of science and strategy that goes into determining the perfect cruising altitude for every flight. We're about to dive into the fascinating world of flight altitudes and uncover the secrets behind those seemingly arbitrary heights. Buckle up, aviation enthusiasts and curious travelers. We're about to explore why planes don't just soar to the highest heights and unravel the delicate balance of factors that keep them cruising at that sweet spot in the sky. When it comes to flying, airlines are always looking for that sweet spot, the altitude where they can achieve the best of three worlds: fuel efficiency, passenger comfort, and optimal safety. And guess what? These three factors are more intertwined than you might think. Let's start with fuel. It's expensive stuff and airlines want to use as little as possible. Turns out the thinner air at higher altitudes creates less drag on the plane. Less drag means less fuel needed to push through the air, which translates to big savings for the airlines. But it's not just about pinching pennies, it's also about your comfort up in the air. Now let's talk about how this whole thin air thing actually works. Imagine trying to run through water versus running on dry land. The water being denser creates more resistance, making it much harder to move. Air works the same way. The higher you go, the less dense the air becomes. For planes, this means less resistance as they fly higher, allowing them to reach faster speeds while using less fuel. It's a win-win for both the airlines and the environment. But hold on, there's a catch. While thinner air might sound great for gliding through the sky, it also poses some unique challenges for our airborne vehicles. Remember that smooth ride you experience while cruising above the clouds? That's no accident. Choosing the right altitude helps pilots avoid turbulent weather, which can make for a pretty uncomfortable flight. You know those pesky thunderstorms and heavy winds? They tend to hang out at lower altitudes. By climbing higher, planes can often fly above these meteorological mayhem makers, giving you a smoother, more enjoyable journey. Plus, who wants to miss out on those breathtaking views above the clouds? But while dodging turbulence is a priority, there's another crucial factor pilots consider at higher altitudes: safety. High stakes in thin air, safety at altitude. Here's the thing. While flying high has its perks, it also requires careful consideration of safety procedures. Remember how we talked about air getting thinner at higher altitudes? Well, that thin air also means less oxygen available both for breathing and for the plane's engines. That's why planes have those handy oxygen masks that drop down in case of cabin pressure loss. And speaking of emergencies, did you know that the time it takes to descend to a safe altitude in case of an emergency is longer at higher altitudes? It's a bit like a trade-off. You get fuel efficiency and smoother rides at higher altitudes, but you're also farther away from the ground if something goes wrong. The sky is not the limit engine power and icy heights. You might be thinking, why not just fly as high as possible then? Well, it's not quite that simple. Even though thinner air means less drag, it also means less air for the engines to suck in and burn for power. And just like us, engines need oxygen to function properly. There's also the issue of temperature. As we climb higher, the air gets colder, and I mean really cold. At cruising altitudes, temperatures can plummet well below freezing. This frigid environment can affect engine performance and even cause ice to form on the plane's wings, which can be dangerous. Stalls, coffins, and speed demons. Flight's tricky trio. Now let's talk about some slightly more technical but super interesting concepts that come into play at higher altitudes. Remember how we said thinner air means less lift? Well, this leads to a phenomenon called a stall. A stall happens when there's not enough air flowing over the wings to generate enough lift to keep the plane airborne. And here's where it gets even more intriguing. There's this thing called the coffin corner, which is a combination of high altitude and high speed where the plane becomes very difficult to control. It's a narrow window where stalling speed and the speed of sound start to converge, making it a particularly challenging situation for pilots. Pilots, the unsung heroes of altitude. With all these factors to consider, fuel efficiency, passenger comfort, safety, engine performance, and even the speed of sound, You might be wondering how on earth pilots keep track of it all. Well, let me tell you, these folks are true professionals, highly trained to handle the complexities of flight at varying altitudes. They use a combination of experience, sophisticated instruments, and constant communication with air traffic control to make real-time decisions about the best altitude for their flight. From monitoring weather patterns to calculating fuel consumption, and even accounting for the weight of the aircraft, pilots are constantly juggling multiple variables to ensure a safe and smooth journey for everyone on board. Up, up, and away. Keep exploring the skies. So there you have it, folks. The next time you're cruising at 35,000 feet, you'll have a whole new appreciation for the delicate balance of factors that go into determining your flight path. It's a fascinating world up there, full of scientific principles, engineering marvels, and the steady hands of skilled pilots who navigate the skies with precision and expertise. Keep asking questions, keep exploring, and keep marveling at the wonders of flight. And hey, if you happen to be seated next to a pilot on your next trip, maybe buy them a drink. They've earned it.